So the Reminders app is very handy, but if you're new to Mac, you may not have started using it yet. So when you run Reminders, you may get one of several different views here. You can create multiple lists inside of Reminders. In this view here, I can use the dots at the bottom to go between them. So I've got a list called Reminders, a shopping list, an ideas list, and one called Gifts. I can more easily see what I've got if I go to View, Show Sidebar, and then I can see them all here listed on the left side and I can jump to them. If I look at Scheduled, I'm basically seeing what upcoming reminders I've got. To add a reminder, I can hit the plus button here. I can hit Command N or File New Reminder. The list that's selected is the one that the reminder will go into. So I'll just use the reminders list called Reminders. I'll add something here like Get Milk. But I could also add a time. So I could say get milk today at 5 p.m. And it actually translates the at 5 p.m. to today at 5 p.m. an actual time. If I hit I there, I will get information and it will say that this reminder is set for on a day and it has a specific time. I can change that by clicking on it. So I can change it to 4, change it to 6. I can change the date, as you can see there. So I can edit it very easily. Now it's important to realize that there are accounts that have to go with reminders because reminders are something that work in the cloud. So if I go to reminders accounts, it will jump to system preferences where it shows me I've got an iCloud account, and in that iCloud account I could see I've got reminders turned on. It is possible to have more than one type of account that uses reminders. So for instance, having a Gmail account with reminders and also an iCloud account with reminders. Notice in the left sidebar I see iCloud and I've got these four lists under iCloud. So it's important to be aware of where the reminders list is located. Hopefully it's simple like it is for me and everything is just under iCloud, which means that these will sync to my iPhone and iPad just without any additional action from me. It just happens automatically. So I'll get the reminder on my iPhone when I'm out today at 6 p.m. to pick up milk. You can click to select any item in here and hit the delete key to delete it. You can check it off to show it's completed. And when you have a reminders list that's empty, you'll get 6 completed, show, and you can show all the completed items. There are a lot of other cool options in here for reminders, and you don't have to use them for things that actually remind you at a specific time. For instance, my ideas list is where I like to put ideas for future episodes for MacMost. And I can just list them here. There's no deadline for any of them. And I can check them off when I do each episode. So it's great for keeping ideas. It's great for shopping lists. It's great for reminders where you want to get an alarm but you don't want to add an item to your calendar. There's all sorts of cool functionality that you can do with reminders. You can create new lists very easily. So create lists to categorize the items that you want to be either to-do items or items for ideas and other things. And just play around with the Reminders app and see how you can use it for your tasks. You can also use Siri with Reminders. So in Reminders you want to set a default list and then you can use Siri to add items. Remind me to get milk.
Okay, I'll remind you.
And you can see it added it automatically. Or I can have Siri add it to a specific list. Add cookies to my shopping list.
I've added it.
Now if I look at shopping list, there, cookies has been added.